Hola todos. Thank you so much for joining me for today's lesson. Once again, this is your amigo, your maestro, Kyungo, welcoming you to Spanish Central. Thank you so much for joining me for today's lesson. Thank you also for continuing to watch the lessons I've already posted. The videos I've already uploaded. Please keep the comments coming. Also, continue subscribe if this is your first time to watch. And for those who are subscribers, thank you for your support. Please keep the comments, the feedback coming, and also continue liking and sharing the videos. Once again, thank you for your support. Now, what do we have today? Today, I'll be talking about two terms that look almost similar. Two terms that look almost similar, actually two words, that phrases, if you will, that almost look similar. And the reason I say they look similar is because the only difference is actually, the only difference between the two is actually only one letter. One letter makes the difference in spelling between the two. But now what you want to note is that they actually mean very different things. Very slight difference in their spelling, but the meanings are totally different. So it's very, I advise pay close attention to these kind of phrases because at times they can be deceptive. Without wasting any much more time or without keeping in suspense any longer, let me tell you the phrases I'm talking about. I'm talking about cuando. Cuando. C-U-A-N-D-O. Cuando and cuanto. Cuando and cuanto. Cuanto, C-U-A-N-T-O. Now, you see the only difference between the two is one is cuando and the other one is cuanto. They may sound similar, but actually they mean very different, very distinctive. They have very distinctive meanings. And let me tell you what these words mean so that you can know how to apply them correctly. And again, the spelling is going to be under there on the lesson where I usually place the notes. Now, cuando, C-U-A-N-D-O, it's an adverb. It's an adverb, we may say a descriptive adverb. And it means when. It means when. In terms of like when it's like how soon, what time, when you want to ask about a specific time, let's say when something is going to be taking place, when. So it's a cuando, it's the English equivalent of when, or its English equivalent is when. So that's number one. Cuando is an adverb that means when. Let's look at the other word or the other phrase. Cuanto. Cuanto is a pronoun. Cuanto is a pronoun that describes quantity. It describes quantity. What am I talking about? Cuanto is the equivalent, English equivalent of how much? How much is it? Or how many? Again, cuanto describes quantity in terms of like how much, you know, when you want to know about the cost. For example, the cost or price of something. Cuanto cuesta? How much does it cost? Okay, so you see why I say that these two words may look similar, but the meanings are very distinct, very different. So like you've seen, like I just broke it down. Cuando is an adverb that means when. Cuando means when. So remember this, cuando means when. Cuando is the English equivalent of, is the Spanish equivalent of when. When. Cuanto is a pronoun. Pronoun describing quantity. And its English equivalent is how much or how many, like when you want to know the cost. So there you go. That's our lesson for today. Like I said, our lesson, very brief, to differentiate or to know how to properly use these two phrases, cuando and cuando. Cuando and cuando. And again, I'm going to give the full explanations in the notes, but the main thing to know is that don't let them, they are not used interchangeably, because cuando means when and cuanto means how much or how many. One thing I want to point out here, like I usually tell you, in Spanish, we have the genders, masculine or feminine. So it, when it comes to cuanto, if you are talking about if the subject is masculine, it's going to be cuanto. If it's feminine, it's going to be cuanto. And if it's singular, it's going to be cuanto. If it's masculine, plural, it's going to be cuantos. If it's feminine, singular, it's going to be cuanta. If it's plural, it's going to be cuantos. But don't worry, I'm going to put all those examples on the notes so you can always go back and revise them at your own leisure. So we come to the end of our lesson today. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please continue. For those who have not subscribed, kindly hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you can be notified whenever I upload a new lesson, which I usually do a lesson every 2 weeks. And for those who have subscribed, thank you for continuing to watch lessons. Thank you for sharing, liking, comment. Kindly continue doing so. Once again, this has been your amigo, Kyongo, telling you muchas gracias. Hasta luego. We'll see you around during the next lesson. Adios.